Right. So. Be aware of health. I keep doing that.
You guys are behind with your payments. What do you, you think just because you're in some gang, you don't have to give Davik his cut?
Ah,
so you want to play this the hard way? Okay.
That's a bit.
Rana no prata don't no sercha. It you a penki.
What on a wama mulira? Kenjun tu pashak. No wa bule mulira ji. Junitun turji chiwi dato. Bola una dicek. Palamure slimo wanga kun bisching.
I knew you boys would see reason. Now get out of here.
Too bad. I was looking forward to cracking some heads.
Maybe next time, Candorous. I better get this over to Davik. I'll call you if anyone else gets behind on their payments.
Eep. What is this? Where does this go? That's the Low City Apartments. We don't want to go there. Hello? Hello? Hello. Goodbye. Don't want to speak to you anyway. Is this... Ah, Sith Guard. What? Oh, there's three of them again. This is annoying. I thought there'd be more. Actually, if I wait for... that. Okay, whittled you down to two. Might be able to take you guys on. Flurry. Maybe I should go back to one weapon. I keep wanting to try out dual wielding, but it's no good for me. How's my health? Not low enough, I think medpack is necessary. Now it is. Thank you, Garth. I'm just wasting my time. Yeah, let's just stick with... Let's stop trying a dual weapon approach. It's not doing us any good whatsoever. A frag grenade back. Wonderful. I thought this guy's a Sith. Oh, this guy is a Sith. Very useful. I'm aware of it.
You've got the proper security papers, you better just turn around and go back the way you came.
Ah, I've got my security papers right here.
Let me see. These look to be in order. Okay, you can go down if you want. Can't say I envy you, though. The Undercity is crawling with mutants. Rackgulls, they call them. If you see anything moving down there, shoot first and ask questions later.
Okay. I don't shoot. This may be a mistake, but I don't shoot. Rack ghouls. They sound horrible. We're gonna get brutally murdered several times, aren't we?
You there! Upworlder! Anyone using this elevator has to pay the toll!
Yeah, this is our elevator. If you use it, you gotta give us something.
I don't believe this planet. Even the beggars are trying to shake us
down. 5 credits! That's what it costs to use our elevator. 5 credits.
Right. Who are you and what are you doing here in the Undercity?
We are the outcasts, banished and reviled by those who dwell above. Here in the filth and darkness, we claw out a wretched existence, scavenging and begging just to survive long enough to see another wretched day.
This is our village. We live here in the Undercity. You have to pay us 5 credits for using our elevator.
But this is about... Do I give them money because they're beggars? I think if they weren't trying to shake me down, maybe, but this is a public elevator. I'm not paying any toll.
Please have pity on us. We have nothing. All we ask is a few credits to make our lives easier.
That's different. So you've got the kind of dark side. I don't know what that's probably dark side. That's dark side. That's probably more neutral, maybe. That's light side. That's very light side. I don't know what to do. We've got the money, and I know I won't spend it later in the game. or if I do, I don't know. The thing is, if I argue that, do I then get to argue later? Oh yeah, I paid a lot more than 5 last time, so you should count it. We need these guys on side anyway, don't we? Do I give the 20? Yeah, I'll, yes.
Credits, my brother! We have credits. Now we can buy food and medicine.
Hush! The others will hear us. They'll want our credits. We have to hide them.
Go on, you two. Get out of here. I'm sorry about that. Those two beggars give everyone in the village a bad name. We aren't all like that, you know. Most of us are good people.
I'm sure you are, miss. It's just too bad your little welcoming committee is here to give people a bad first impression.
My name is Tail Delwyn. Who are you?
My name is Shalina. You're from the Upworld, aren't you? I've never seen it. I was born here in the Undercity. Is it as nice as they say up there?
It's better than here. It is a beautiful place. Relative to what? But it's a beautiful place. We'll say that. I mean, how long have we actually spent there?
I've never been to the surface, but sometimes I think I can see it in my dreams. The sun, the sky, the stars. It all sounds so wonderful. Yendar, the leader of our village, tells me I should spend more time trying to improve things down here and less time dreaming about something I can never have. Maybe he's right. You'd probably think I'm a fool, having dreams of a place I've never even seen. But when I was little, Rukil used to tell me stories of what it was like up there.
Who's that?
Rukil's the oldest man in the village. The kids call him Rukil Wrinkleskin, but he's a kind man. He used to tell me the greatest stories when I was a little girl. I still like to listen to his tales about the Promised Land, even though I know they're just legends, but it helps to make the Undercity seem less dark somehow.
What's the Promised Land?
It's just a story to make little children smile. Rukil believes in it, though. Sometimes I can almost believe it myself, but then I look around and see the ugly truth. I guess we have to make the best of what we have, though. If you really want to learn more about the Promised Land, you should speak to Rukil.
Where can I find him?
He's wandering around somewhere on the south side of the village. He doesn't move too far. He's hard on his bones. He's over 100 years old. The children laugh at him, and people think he's crazy because of his stories about the Promised Land, but he's really just a kind old man.
Where can I find Gendar?
He'll be somewhere in the village. I couldn't say where for sure. He's always busy doing whatever he can to make the lives of the other villagers easier.
Do you know anything about the escape pods that crashed here?
I don't know anything about that, but maybe Gendar could help you. Sorry. Is there anything else you need?
Have any other upworlders come through recently?
There were quite a few people from the surface marching through the village, but none of them bothered to talk to me. Gendar might know more about them.
Oh, thank you. I'll be going now.
Oh, okay. Well, if you ever need anything, or if you just feel like talking, come back and see me. I hardly ever get a chance to speak to someone from the upworld.
Aww. License point gained! They will not be the last. Tiny amount of... Tiny wee amount of light sides. Alright, helps if I press the right buttons. No.
Yes?
Oh yeah, yes. Outcast man. He's my least favorite superhero. The tower of not being noticed. Like, the power of not being noticed. Outcast healer.
Wait, Upworlder. You can't go through this gate. There is too much danger and suffering beyond. For your own sake, turn back.
I thought you just healed people. That's why I'm here. Because I wouldn't mind a little bit of healing, but... Okay, who are you?
I am Isala, healer of this village. I use my knowledge and what little resources we have to care for the outcasts who are sick or injured. But despite my medical training, there is nothing I can do to help the poor souls locked on the other side of this gate.
What are you talking about?
The villagers infected with the Rukgul disease are quarantined beyond this gate. It's only a matter of time until they transform into horrible creatures that would destroy us all.
So you just lock them away in a cage?
For the sake of the village, we have to keep the infected ones locked away. And when they finally do transform into Rukguls, we'll let them destroy each other.
There must be something someone can do.
Nothing can be done for the infected villagers. Even the serum to counteract the Rukgul disease wouldn't be any use now. Nobody would be foolish enough to risk going into the pens to give them the cure. The infected ones could transform into Rukguls and attack them at any moment.
Do we just leave the infected ones to die? I want to ask some questions.
If you have questions, you should speak to Gendar. He's the leader of the issue. All my attention has to stay focused on trying to ease the suffering of those within the village. But despite my medical training, there is nothing I can do to help the poor souls locked on the other side of this gate.
Yeah, it's kind of looping around, isn't it? Kind of. Yeah. I need healing. Yay, we got healed. Yes. Shalina's over there, Rukil. Gendar. Let's talk to Rukil.
You come from the world above. Is this the time of destiny then? Is this a portent of the salvation of my people? Or merely another false sign to mislead us from the path? Are you the herald of prophecy? The beacon to guide us through the darkness? Or are you merely another harbinger of shattered dreams and unfulfilled promises?
Be careful. This one might be crazy enough to be dangerous.
Speak to me, Upworlder. Tell me what fate you unleash upon us. Salvation or damnation? Speak, Upworlder. I beg you.
What are you talking about?
Question. You are uncertain, bewildered, perplexed. Understandable, I suppose. Even after 100 years of life, I myself still become confused at times. Perhaps I can make things more clear. Some things, at least. My name is Rukil, the oldest outcast here in the village. Rukil Wrinkleskin, the children call me sometimes.
I'm Tail Delwyn. What do you want from me, Rukil?
Once, I was honored for my wisdom. But over time, the villagers fell away from the true path. Eventually, there was only a single apprentice who followed me. And now she is gone, too.
What true path? Now, what happened to your apprentice?
My apprentice is... lost. I sent her out into the Undercity to find... Well, I cannot tell you. Not yet. Sadly, my apprentice has not returned. Please, Upworlder, will you help an old man? Will you seek out my apprentice in the Undercity? Her name is Malia. I must know of her fate, whatever it may be. I must know what she found.
I will help you.
Finding her may be difficult. Malia could be anywhere in the Undercity. But if you will find her, I will know you to be our true savior. Only then can I reveal my secret knowledge to you.
I'll be back if I find anything.
I wish you luck, Upworlder. Come speak to me again once you have discovered the fate of my apprentice.
Hooray! So we're probably the person that he's talking about. Though we haven't found Mission yet. The person we've come to visit. We'll talk to is it Jendar?
Greetings, Upworlder. We rarely see your kind here in the Undercity. I find it strange that so many of you have come down from the surface recently.
No offense, but I can see why people normally avoid this place.
Why have you come into this dark and sunless place? Is there something you need of me or my village? I will help you however I can.
You said something about other upworlders came here recently.
Our village has seen many visitors from the surface recently. Armored troops, swoop gang members, mercenaries. They come to search our sunless world. They're even searching the sewers.
Well, I'm looking for a Twi'lek named Mission Veo.
Yes, I have seen this Twi'lek many times, though I've never spoken to her. She and her Wookiee companion often pass through our village on their way to explore the sewers.
How can I get to the sewers?
There are two entrances into the sewers from the Undercity. One to the northeast of our village, the other to the southeast. But the sewers are dangerous, Upworlder. If you dare to travel those dark tunnels, you would be wise to go heavily armed, unless you wish to become a meal for the Rakghouls and the other foul creatures.
I want to ask some other questions. One about Rakghouls, hopefully.
Ask your questions, Upworlder. I will answer to the best of my knowledge, though I know little beyond the borders of the Undercity.
Tell me about the Rakghouls.
The Rakghouls are monsters, hideous mutations who feast on the flesh of our villagers. Their diseased jaws can infect those they attack, transforming the victim into one of those abominations. We know of no cure for the disease, and for the good of the village, we must banish any who become infected, lest they transform and turn on us.
So that's why there's the people in the cage. I think that's it, isn't it?
As you wish, Upworlder. Should you have need of anything else, come speak to me. I represent the entire village, and I will do my best to help you however I can.
Hooray! So, we need to go and find this fellow's apprentice. We need to go and find, head into the sewers to find Mission Veo. We don't actually. How do I even leave this place? That's probably something to work on, isn't it? There's Shalina. I assume this is a tent rather than a. Yes, I didn't think that was a way out. Sorry, Garth. So, is the exit around here somewhere? Aha! I assume this is the exit. So, we're going to be fighting these Rakghoul. Before we get to them, I assume we're going to be talking to Hester over there. And head out. Head towards the sewers. What's that? Ooh, a shop! That I will forget to use. So that's the end of this today. Next time, we'll be heading out looking for Mission, looking for this apprentice, and from there, hopefully getting Bastila from the hand of the... whoever they are. I've already forgotten. Regal's apprentice, yes. From the Volcars, yes. Yes. I'm going to think about if we're doing anything about those Rakghoul fellows, people over there. But that will be next time. Thanks for watching, everyone. Thanks for watching.